Welcome to Radiologic Technology 86, Fluoroscopy and Radiation Safety. At this point in the radiography program, you've gone through radiographic positioning requirements for various body parts and exam types. You've been taught how to acquire high image quality at low radiation doses, optimizing the technical factors available to you, and you've acquired opportunities to practice these skills on a daily basis in your clinical rotations at various hospitals across San Diego County. You may be feeling the routine x-ray exams becoming more fluid, and you're gaining efficiency at performing them, along with consistent improvement in your patient's care skills. You're well on your way to becoming registered technologists in radiography. As a registered technologist, it's important for you to recognize that you'll be the expert in your field. Right now, as a student, you'll be supervised directly or indirectly while performing radiologic examinations. You possess a basic set of skills to perform them, which you'll be spending the remainder of your student experience and beyond continuing to improve upon. But once you're fully credentialed, it will be your responsibility to not only perform these examinations independently without supervision, but to be that resource, that expert in your field for other hospital employees, nurses, and other radiography students, and most importantly, for patients and their families. There's still a lot to learn in your studies to separate the technologists from the technicians or the limited license personnel. As a technologist and expert in your field, you'll need to have an in-depth understanding of state and national rules and regulations involving your equipment, the radiation it produces, and how to perform your duties safely for general radiographic examinations as well as fluoroscopy. You'll need to understand the physics and the potential effects and dose limits of radiation in order to keep yourself, your patients, and your peers as safe as possible while operating this highly technical equipment. Contrary to popular belief, technologists don't simply push a magic button all day long. While a great technologist will be able to make the role look just that easy, it's the knowledge and mastery of those concepts, along with consistent practice of them, in an attempt to continually improve upon what you've learned, which separates us as medical professionals. In this course, we'll be breaking down the radiation safety regulations we're expected to uphold as technologists and focusing on best practices of radiation safety as it applies to fluoroscopic examinations. We'll take a brief look at some of the potential outcomes if we fail to observe these standards, though a more thorough understanding of those effects on the human body will be covered in your radiation biology course. Here we'll be reviewing the practice-based guidelines mandated by state and federal regulations, as well as taking a look at hospital policies surrounding fluoroscopy with a focus on patient care. We'll also be covering the fluoroscope itself, its components, how the fluoroscope operates, and some quality control testing that we, as technologists, can perform to ensure it's working properly and within permissible specifications to maintain a safe working environment. The second half of this course will be accompanied by a fluoroscopic lab where you can practice these skills. With that, I'd like to welcome you to the course. We'll be utilizing a lot of resources for this information over the course of the semester, which I'll be outlining as we go. So welcome, and please feel free to reach out with any questions. You can find my contact information on the course syllabus. Please take a moment before diving into Module 1 to review the syllabus, the course schedule, and to check assignment, quiz, and test due dates.